Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are doing well. I am here again with maths class. And yesterday we have studied about percentage, and I explained you that percent. What does this percent stands for? Percent is made up of two parts, per and cent, where per stands for every and cent stands for 100. Percent means for every 100. So yesterday we learned how to convert the fractions into percentage and how to convert some fractions by making the denominator or by changing the denominator into 100. And one more we studied yesterday, that how to convert a decimal number into percent. So today we will study where we can apply the knowledge of this percent in our daily life. Here you can see I have written say. You must have gone to market during festive season and you must have seen hoardings like 25% or sale of 25%, 30% discount and 10% discount. So today we will learn how to know that how much discount is there in a particular item, article or cloth. So for an example, let's take a jacket. There is a sale of 25%. So now we will find out what does this 25% stand for. Actually, we know that 25% means 25 of per 100. It is in the form of fraction. And we know that whenever we have to convert a percentage in the form of fraction, we write the percent number in numerator and in denominator 100. Now we have to find out the 25% of the jacket. And the cost of jacket, let's take the cost of jacket is ₹900. And we have to find out the 25% of this jacket. And how we will find out? This 25% means in 100 we will get a discount of 25 rupees. Now we have to find out the 25% of 900. So for that, what we will do? 25% of 900. It is 25% of 900. In place of multiply will come and 900. So here what we can do? As in denominator, two zeros are there. 1, 2 and in numerator also 2 zeros are there. So 0, 0 cancel out. We can say 100 nines are 900. Now we will multiply this 25 by 9. When we will multiply this 25 by 9, what we will get? We will get 9 5s are 45, 9 2s are 18, 18 plus 4, 22. So we will get a discount of ₹225. So, if you have to purchase this jacket, so how much you will pay? You will subtract this discounted amount from the original price of that jacket. You will get 5, 7 and 6. So, after a discount of 25% on the jacket, you will get that jacket in ₹675. So let's find out 10% of something. Suppose there is a discount of 10% on jeans and the cost of that jeans is 750 rupees. So same process we will follow. How to find out 10% of 750? We all know that this 10% stands for 10 by 100. And here the 10 means discount of 10 rupees in per 100, and we have to find out discount of 10% in rupees 750. So here this 0 and this 0 and this 0 and this 0, we will cancel these two 0 and these two zeros. Now we will get 1 multiplied by 75 is equals to 75. So in this rupees 750, we will get a discount of rupees 75 when we will subtract 75 from this 5, 7, so we have to pay ₹675 for this jeans after a discount of 10%. In the same way, you can find out 30% of any article which you will buy. Now, apart from this, let's take one more example from our real life where we can use the knowledge of percentage. So, that is your marks. So, let's start. Suppose there are two students, Amit and Sumit. Amit got 92 out of 100 and Sumit got 175 out of 200. And we have to find out who got good percentage or whose marks were better. So what we will do? For finding out whose percentage was better, we will multiply this fraction by 100. So what we will do? We will multiply this fraction by 100. So here we can see this 100 cancels this 100. 100 versus 100. So it is equals to 92%. And here these two zeros and these two zeros will cancel. We can say 100 twos are 200. Now we have to divide this 175 by 2. I can do it directly. If you will find any problem in doing directly, you can divide it separately. 2 8s are 16. Then 1 will go there. 2 7s are 14.5. So the percentage of Amit is 92% and the percentage of Sumit is 87.5%. As we know, this percent stands for per 100. So if Sumit would have given test out of 100, he would have got the marks 87.5%. And here, as Amit has given test from 100 out of 100, his percentage is 92%. So who scored better? Amit scored better. Suppose somebody asks you how much percent you got in your fourth class or how much percent you got in unit test 1. So how will you find out the percentage of your marks? So for that, you should know two things. First, how much marks you obtained, like total marks which you obtained. And second thing, total number of marks out of which you obtained that marks. So let's understand it in better way. Suppose during your exam, you have given test out of 30. The test paper of one subject, was of 30 marks. And how many subjects are there? Main 4 subjects. So total marks of 4 subjects is equals to 4 into 30. 0. 4 zeros are 0, 4 threes are 12. So total marks are 120. And the main subjects are Hindi, English, Maths and EVS. So these are the main subjects and 30-30 marks of each subject. So total marks are 120 and suppose you get 28 in English, 29 in Hindi, 25 in EVS and 30 in Maths. So what we will do? First we will add these marks. So marks obtained. This will be the marks obtained. What marks you got in exam? For that we have to add 30 plus 25 plus 28 plus 29. So here I will add directly. I will not write in the column form.
Let's add 9 plus 8, 17. 17 plus 5, 22. 2 will come down, 2 carry, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 2, 11. So this 120 is total marks. Now we will find out percentage. Equals to 112 by total marks 120 multiplied by 100. Here we will cancel zeros. Then 2 6s are 12 and 2 5s are 10. Now let's multiply. 5 2s are 10. 0 will come down. 5 1s are 5. 6. 5 1s are 5 divided by 6. Now let's divide it directly. 6 9s are 54. Then 2 0 6 3s are 18. 0.6 3s are 18. And 6 3s are 18%. So we can say you got 93.33% marks in your unit test.
So this was about how to find out the percentage of marks you obtained during exam. And after this, I will tell you the method how to find out the marks obtained by you or somebody if you know the percentage. Suppose your friends tells you that I got 98% or I got 85%. So how will you find out how much marks he or she got? So for that, you have to follow a method that I will explain you. Suppose your friend tells you that he got 98% marks or she got 98% marks in UT1, and you know very well that total marks is equals to 120, and you know the percent of your friend. So as I told you yesterday, 98% means 98 by 100, 98 per 100, then multiplied by 120. Here total marks will come and it is the percentage of your friend. Now this zero we will cancel it. Then 2 6 are 12, 2 5 are 10. We will divide this 12 and this 10 by 2. Now let's multiply this 98 by 6. 48, 8, 6 are 48, 9, 6 are 54, 54 plus 4, 58 by 5. So let's divide this 588 by 5. 5 ones are 5, then 5 ones are 5, 3, 8, 5 sevens are 35, 0.56 are 30. It means your friend got 117.6 marks. So in this way, you can find out the marks obtained by your friend or marks obtained by somebody. And now you have to do one thing for me, that just find out the percentage of your marks which you got in unit test 1. And after that, you can send it to me. I'll be waiting for your percentage. It's not necessary that send that percentage in class group. You can send it personally to me. So here are today's class finishes. Tomorrow we will start next exercise. So thank you. Have a nice day and take good care of yourself.